So for the first time ever, the billion-dollar self-help industry is being shaken through technology. And for someone like me, a licensed therapist and life coach who's been working online solely for the last 7 years, this is really exciting because the current system that we have is broken. It's broken. And I'll tell you why. Three reasons. One, the new generation, they want their coach or therapist or whoever's helping them on their phone. It's all about on-demand access now. So this idea of getting into your car and driving to your therapist's office is long gone. And because of that, problem number two, just because you're certified or you have a license doesn't mean you get a full practice these days. You have to have an online presence, and that can take years. So what we do is we have a sea of people that passionately want to help people, but they are stuck behind this virtual wall and they can't reach their clients, which leaves them frustrated and discouraged. The third problem is there's no single platform that organically connects people that want help with people that want to give help, and doing it in a way where there's a cycle, and you can also get certified as a life coach and have an instant pop-up practice where you have an audience immediately. So that's why we created Shift.
So we're all constantly shifting. Our lives are always changing. But what we might not realize is that there's actually a cycle to human change. And that cycle first starts with contemplation, then preparation, action, and maintenance. When you introduce technology to this cycle, it creates a viral loop that changes the way we change and has people helping people. Now imagine Anne. She's a 42-year-old dentist. She's going through a tough divorce. Anne goes onto the Shift app and goes on the communication platform where she's talking to other women that are going through similar problems, including a divorce. This is moderated by our life coaches and happens through channels and tags. She also receives custom curated content that gives her solutions and possible tools that she can implement in her life to get her through whatever this challenge is. Then she can go ahead and pay to be part of individual one-on-one life coaching, closed accountability groups, or just general content courses. Once she's emerged through whatever transition that she's had to go through, the best way for her to retain the solution that she's found is to share that solution with other people through communicating with them. But there's more. Anne has the opportunity to actually become a life coach and help other people. She re-enters this cycle as someone who's actually earning money by helping other people. And on top of that, she's not just helping other people, she's helping herself. Her journey of self-betterment continues. And this is how we create the viral loop of people helping people.
Questions?
So how is this, I can see how it's different than going to a therapist's office and sitting on a couch. How is this better?
So going to a therapist and sitting on the couch is quickly fading. It's better because you can throw a giant net this way, and this also has that organic hero's journey, wounded healer, very empowering loop that we think can reach, unlimited amount of people.
There's also the concept of mutual vulnerability. Like in the traditional model, you're sitting on a couch and talking and the therapist is listening, but the therapist isn't saying, I'm hurt too, I struggle as well, this is what I go through. With this model, we're able to empathize with each other and be mutually vulnerable, and therefore share our own experience, strength, and hope, and empower others through journeys that we've already traveled.
Super interesting idea here. Is it possible, since generally speaking, you go through transitions in your life, right? Adolescence to young adult to professional to homeowner, etc. Through these different times in your life, you're faced with different challenges. Is there a way to see that the global demographic on everybody in like your age range and then learn with you as your cycle goes to help, basically be like that pat on the back and be like, hey, other people, 2% of people in your same type of situation are going through this too. So having some of that support there, learning, grow with you to stay with life.
That's really interesting. We hadn't previously thought about tracking data and taking like a macro look at it, but by being able to have, through the communication platform, have channels and tags and whatever you're talking about, we're able to put people that are going through the same thing in the same channel. And so they can share their experience. And one of the most empowering things with going through a challenge in life is coming to the realization that you're not the only one that goes through it. That it's like everyone struggles with this type of thing. And you can be supported by others that are battling the same thing. But we hadn't thought about collecting data, and it's definitely not something that we'll be including in our first pass.
So I admit I'm on the far end of not being a very trusting person. So I'm wondering if on a system like this, if I was seeking some help, there's an opportunity, you know, I could be talking about things that I really want very few people to know about. So, this is kind of like a two-part question. Is all this text-based, or is there also, you know, a voice-based system? And the second part is, what's in place to make people feel comfortable that what they're saying or writing isn't going to be going out in the open?
Well, you do always have the option to be anonymous, whether you create a fake name or have a picture of your dog as your profile picture.
Right.
You don't have to actually identify who you are and where you live. But to the second part of your question, which I'm trying to grasp again.
Well, the second part was, I mean, that answered the second part pretty well. So the first part then, is it all text-based? Is that all the communication, or is there a vocal?
No, you're going to be able to connect any way you want, even through a location to meet up at a coffee shop.
Okay.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.